Good afternoon, ma'am. We are ACT students of Bulacan State University, and we're here to ask some questions regarding issues and concerns of students and teachers in school.
Okay. Yes, I hope I can answer your questions properly.
My name is Samuel Calveribaya.
My name is Julian Bianca Dalmasio.
My name is Leifer Des Gonzalez.
My name is Aaron Michael D.J. Leoncio.
And I am Faye Gonzalez.
As we all know, bullying is one of the common issues in our country, especially in schools. Can you tell us how your school prevented this kind of bullying?
In our school, we always educate our students about the Anti-Bullying Act. And we have this governing body called the Child Protection Committee, which upholds the laws of the child protection policy, which is to promote to protect every learner from any forms of abuse, discrimination, exploitation, including bullying.
What can you say about student discrimination? Where rich kids should only be friends with rich kids, and average should also do the same.
Student discrimination. You know, in the Department of Education, in every public school, we promote not only gender equality, but equality, status equality. It doesn't matter if you come from rich family or from poor family. We always educate the child to be always fair, to always mingle to anybody, and to not consider the richness or the being poor of a person to mingle with them.
Teachers must be a good role model to the students. What if the teacher is the one who bully and discriminate the students? What will you do?
I don't think that will happen, but if that case happens, then the teacher should be reprimanded, and if found guilty, the teacher can be either administratively or criminally charged, depending on the gravity of the offense.
Do you think it's right to ask too much payment for books and other school expenses, such as projects and school activities?
That of course, that's not right. Because in public schools, we advocate the no collection policy. We do not collect any payments, especially payments for books, because books in DepEd are free. They are given for free to students to be used. Well, in private schools, since they are private, I think they have the freedom to do that.
Can you tell us your views and opinions about a teacher having his or her child in his or her class advisory? Do you think it's a little bit unfair for the students knowing that one of their classmates is a son or daughter of the teacher?
I don't think so. The relationship of a child to a teacher outside the school should not affect the teaching learning process or the teacher and the student relationship in school. It doesn't mean that if you have your mother as your teacher, you will have higher grades. It will not also mean that if you are a child of a teacher, you will be favored or everything will be easy for you. Madami namang nanonood, madami namang makakakita, makakaklase. So they will know. So mag-iingat ang pagkita, mag-iingat din ang pagkita.
How do you show your students that you understand them and their frustrations?
By simply listening to them. Who knows, they might just need somebody. somebody to listen to, or they might not, they might just need somebody to talk to. Listening to what a learner thinks is a very effective way of making him understand that he is just like any other learners. Hindi siya special, katulad natin ang iba.
How do you motivate students? What are the several effective ways to motivate students toward active participation in the learning process?
I motivate students by making them realize that they are also a necessity in the classroom, that they are important in the classroom, and also acknowledging or giving recognition to even the very simple accomplishments that a learner did. Just giving him a simple comment, just giving him the simple, that's very good. That simply will, that alone will motivate a child. That alone, the simple, very good, nice, that's nice. Just telling him those words would motivate a child or a learner.
What are the characteristics of an effective teacher?
An effective teacher is the one that can handle his class well. An effective teacher gives instructions and follows his own instructions. An effective teacher gives his own rules and follows his own rules. For example, if he wants his students to wear a proper uniform, he must show them first that he himself follows his own rule. You tell your students, or you wear your ID, you wear your proper uniform, then you are not wearing your own uniform and you are not wearing your ID. That's not good. If you set rules, you also follow.
What is your philosophy of teaching?
Philosophy in teaching is a teacher saves lives and directs lives. And a teacher leads his students towards triumphs and success.
How do you measure students' performance in your classroom?
We measure students' performance by giving them different kinds of tests, like a teacher made test, standardized test. We also give them oral examinations, written examinations, and we use rubrics to measure their performances. Sometimes we ask them to simulate or to practice the skills that we teach them.
Who influenced you to become a teacher?
My eldest sister, because my eldest sister is a teacher person. And besides, the nearest college in our place only offers education course. I had no choice. But now, I never regret being a teacher. That being a teacher and that teaching is the noblest profession.
What can you do to combat
anger payment? I just let him to release his anger, let him talk until he gets tired. For him to understand, so that and then we will really talk and get to know what caused his anger.
What is your greatest professional achievement?
My greatest professional achievement is promoted to Principal 3. It is no longer appropriate. It should be Principal 3.
What part of this job do you personally find most satisfying, most challenging?
Okay. Most satisfying. The most satisfying part of my job, I get most satisfied when I solve difficult problems, especially problems concerning my students, our students and teachers. And the most satisfying one is being acknowledged, especially by the stakeholders. When I say stakeholders, these are the parents.
What are the major qualifications for success in this
profession? The major qualification for the success in this profession, for you to be to become a successful teacher, you must have a passion for children. You must love children. You must have a big heart.
Thank you.